Hey guys, today I wanted to give you an update on how my sales are going so far in 2020. And so far, so good. Sales have been really increasing from last year, and we'll get right into it. I'll give you my last 12 months of sales and basically just show you how everything's going and explain how you can get close to or to this level one day by scaling with some of the tips that I'm going to give you later in the video. So make sure you watch it until the end to see those tips. So first things first is so far we're right now we're February 25th, and so far this year I've done almost 450,000 in sales, which over last year we can see in January I did 146,000. This year I did 216, so not a huge increase, about 70K more. But February has seen a huge increase from last year. Last year was 80,404 units sold, and that's through the whole month of February. And now, so far, just this year, we can see that we're 25 days into February, so we got 4 days left since it's a leap year this year. And I'm already at 1,037 units and $232,000 in sales. So should end the month probably with another 40,000 or so. So probably about 275,000, because I've been averaging close to 10,000 a day, just a little bit under that. So I'm really happy with how this year's looking so far. And then we can see, like last year, we went up to like 300,000 in sales in May. So I'm really looking forward to seeing like what those numbers are going to be this year, since we can already see that I'm at like over 100% increase from last year in terms of the first 2 months of the year. So I did like 2.6 million last year, and I mean, if I keep this 100% up, then I'll be over 5 million, which is my goal this year, is to hit 5 million in sales on Amazon.com. So we'll see if I can hit that. I set that goal at the beginning of this year, like thinking, okay, that's probably not going to be possible, but I'm going to do whatever it takes to get to that. So I can see that I'm already on pace, not necessarily on pace to do 5 million because I've only done like 250,000 a month, but I'm on pace in the sense that I'm 100% increase. So if I can keep the 100% increase up, then I'll be at like 5.2 million by the end of this year. So the reason that I'm able to scale so much more is the fact that I have more capital. Each year that I make more money, then I can reinvest it into additional inventory. So I know I've talked about this before, but it is a very key point in growing your Amazon FBA business. If you want to grow your Amazon FBA business, you need to reinvest your profits. Not everything, you need to obviously take some money out to live, but you need to reinvest a lot of the money that you're making in order to scale the business. And then eventually you get to a point where you're doing like, if I hit 5 million in sales this year, then I can take out more money and not have to keep everything in the business. But the fact of the matter is, the more that you keep in the business, the more money that you're going to make, because the more inventory that you can buy, and if you have fast moving inventory, then that just means it's going to sell a lot quicker. So I'm already really happy with this year and really looking forward to see how I can scale and grow more and more. And I'm thinking within the next 2 to 3 years, I can have this company to 10 million in sales per year on Amazon.com. So really looking forward to that and figuring out more and more ways to scale. One of the other key things that is involved in me getting to this level is the use of prep centers. So I use multiple different prep centers, and then that allows me to keep moving a bunch of inventory without having to hire a bunch of employees. So by having these prep centers, it saves me on employee costs. Even though prep centers do charge, it's still making me so much more money than if I was just to try to do it all on my own, because that wouldn't be physically possible to be moving this much inventory. And obviously, I'm selling items that are on average $217 this year, so that's went down a little bit from 241 last year, but it's a lot of bigger products, because obviously a $200 product is likely going to be bigger. So the stuff that I'm moving is quite large, and that can be difficult to handle and everything. So that's why I like to get the prep centers to help with that, and that is a huge component in scaling your Amazon FBA business is to use prep centers. Now, if you are just starting out, you don't necessarily have to use it. If you're just selling like, I don't know, 10 items a week or so, then you can do it on your own. You can send your stuff into FBA on your own and you don't need to get prep centers involved. And then you can basically save as much money as possible and increase your bottom line. But once you get to a certain point, and if you don't want to hire employees and buy a big warehouse and stuff like that, then the way around it is to use prep centers. So let's go to my sales for the last 12 months. So we're just going to take this to February 25th, 2019. And we can see I'm at 2.83 million in the last 12 months. So definitely happy with these numbers as well. Almost 3 million US dollars in sales in a 12 month period. 12,764 units shipped and an average sales per order item of $235.60. And a lot of people have asked me, why do you have such a high average sales per order item? Like, why do you sell such high value items? And that's kind of my niche. That's what I teach other people how to do. Obviously, people just starting out with a small amount of money to invest, say you have like $500 to invest, then you're not going to be able to get into high value items. I don't recommend that for anyone just starting out. But once you build, say, your inventory to like where you can have $10,000 to invest in inventory, that's where you can start getting into higher value items, because higher value items yield a higher profit, because it's just sheer numbers. Like on a $235 item, if it's a 20% profit margin, then I'm making almost $50 per unit. Whereas if you have a 20% profit margin and you're selling $10 items, you're only gonna make $2 per unit. So that's why I like larger items. I like when I sell the item, I'm gonna make more profit per item. There's nothing wrong with selling lower value items, but just for my niche and what I figured out works best for me is the high value items on Amazon.com. So that is what I teach in my course, how to sell high value items, how to source them, how to make money with them, how to even compete against Amazon with them, and how to beat Amazon in the buy box when they are selling the exact same item as you. So I figured out all these things and it's allowed me to grow the business to 2.6, 2.7 million in sales in 2019, and then about 2.8 million in the last 12 months. So as I continue to scale the business, keep reinvesting my profits, the business is only going to continue to grow. And that's the awesome thing with Amazon, is when you can ship all your items to either prep centers or directly to Amazon's warehouse. I don't mean directly in the sense that directly from your supplier, but directly from your house or your warehouse or your prep center directly to their warehouses, is a great thing, because you don't have to buy a big warehouse or lease a big warehouse, and you can actually do this just from your own house, especially if you're just starting out, or with the use of prep centers. Then you never have to even touch the inventory, and the only time you might see it is if you get returns, and then you have to get those returns back at some point. So some people will just dispose of their returns, but obviously with high value items, you want to get them back. So that's kind of the gist of how I've got to this point. Basically, the two key points are reinvesting your profits and using prep centers would be like the two main components of me growing to this level. And then obviously the last thing is the fact that I sell high value items. That's going to get me to a lot higher sales. It's going to get me to a lot higher sales numbers with selling high value items. But it's not only that that I've got to this point, because I'm still moving 12,000 items in the year. So basically the thing with Amazon FBA is you can make a lot of money with it, but you have to still be very dedicated. It's not as easy as people think. So if you've been thinking about getting started selling on Amazon, but you're not sure where to start, feel free to shoot me an email. My email is Amazon and eBay Guru, all one word, and then at gmail.com. You can send me an email if you have any questions, and then obviously I'll also have my course in the description below. It's called the FBA Freedom Course, and you can look into that as well, where I give you a step-by-step guide in how to get started on Amazon and then also how to scale your business. But Basically, these numbers just show that Amazon is not dead. Amazon is not slowing down. We can see my sales have already grown 100% compared to last year. So even though there's more sellers, there's still so many opportunities and more people are shopping on Amazon. So it just allows for a bigger opportunity for sellers like you and I. So if you haven't started, make sure you start now because I highly recommend, even if you don't buy my course or contact me, just get started on Amazon because it's the platform that's continuously growing and allows you to make a lot of money. And eventually you can get to the point where you're making a full-time income. So thanks for watching this video and don't forget to check out my other videos and to subscribe to my channel for more. Thanks for watching, guys.